How it feels to raise an autistic child on the inside.
Anyway, welcome to Take the Bait, episode 23. Raymond.
Okay, I'm about to spoil everything we're about to talk about.
No, first, because there's some stuff that you don't know I'm going to talk about, because I've been doing some secret things.
Yeah, I'm a spoiler. I don't know yet, but... okay.
You're going to predict it?
Yeah.
All right. While my dogs are having a breakdown in the background, go ahead.
They're fighting. Break it up.
Spoil the episode, Raymond. Go.
Okay, you're going to talk about Scott. You're going to talk about Jack film. You're going to talk about... you're going to talk about the party. No, you already talked about the party, you and ASAP. What else are you going to talk about?
So, I have reinstated... I have reinstated the podcast Twitter account. It is back, Raymond.
Wait, for real? With this, wait.
I made
with the same.
I made a new one.
Email?
I made a new one.
With the same email?
No, I made a new one with a different email. I'll give you that info later.
God damn it! How am I gonna get access to
that? I'm gonna give it to you because I made a brand new email for it. So we officially have a new Take the Bait account. It's at Take the Bait Pod because I couldn't get the username I wanted. So it's really bad right now.
Crap. My pants.
Honestly, agree. I can't wait to give you the password because you're gonna love it.
Okay.
Because I didn't want to make.
Is it just shitting on me?
No, it's just a bad password.
Oh, okay.
Oh, speaking of bad passwords, Raymond, you got hacked.
Why do I have this image?
Speaking of bad passwords, Raymond, you got hacked. Stop sending me this photo of a man shooting himself. Talk about getting hacked.
So I have the same password for every account I ever own.
Indeed, and I know what it is.
You do? What is it?
I'm not gonna say it because I actually care about other people's privacy.
No,
I'm like,
pause. Pause.
Okay. Yeah, I do know it.
Well, at least you don't know the emails.
I only. That's all you need. No. You need to understand. I know it because you told me it one time a long time ago.
Oh.
It was when.
Wait, no, you actually just have access to my account at any time.
No, because I don't. One, I don't care. Two, I don't know your emails. Three, the reason you gave it to me was because when we were trying to find the original Big Madison P server, so you just gave me your password when it was like, just figure out which account it is. I'm like, alright. And now we're here, where you got hacked, and it was not by me. As much as I'm trying to gaslight you into thinking it was not.
You did successfully do that. I was about to go off on you.
Yeah, I thought that was really funny.
Yeah. Yeah, but I got hacked. Just randomly. I just woke up today, and I'm like, oh, let me talk to my Instagramians. And then,
I was texting you all morning. I had so much going on that I was telling you about.
Yeah, you did. And I saw it all, but, like, right when I was about to get to the last, like, message, the notification popped up. So it was like a horrible cliffhanger that was left off of.
I sent you the greatest image in the world. I'm gonna.
So,
I sent you
the notification. The notification was like you were locked out of this account because someone changed the password. And I'm like, I didn't change the password. So even if I wanted it back, I don't even know what this guy's password could have changed it to.
The image I sent you was like one of the last things I said to you before you got hacked. Which I just like to imagine that the hacker is looking through your DMs and just sees a Peter alert.
Thank God I don't got nothing like personal there, so that's good.
Hello, I'm back. Yeah, of course, awesome. Okay, welcome back, Raymond. So. I think it's really funny. I want to explain what my interruption was because My dogs were going crazy, and the reason
They're going
was
crazy.
they were, and the reason was because like father ordered something, and don't text me at 9 when we're already recording the podcast. Anyway, because
Rare.
father ordered something, and under the special instructions, like specifically put do not ring or knock, like just don't do that. And they knocked 4 times. So
Oh my God.
my dogs were going crazy because there was a guy knocking 4 times. That's cool. Love
That's amazing.
that. Anyway, should we get into the topics? We actually have topics for this time.
But I got a video. Look at my video. That sigh of
Someone
defeat.
please help. Hey, oh thank God
I'm a
you.
vegan.
Cool. I also remember 2017.
What in the 2017? That's my favorite sentence ever. What in the 2017? Like, that's so funny.
I do want to share something. So, okay. What was that?
Or you went awfully quiet after my joke, and I just felt embarrassed.
It's because I was typing something, but what the, I don't want to verify my own account. I'm already verified. I know this is my account. Anyway,
My new account 2 times.
so for on the new Take the Bait account, you know how I always set it up as a business account just to be funny? Instead of doing entertainment, I was looking through all the options because I wanted to see if there were any like actually funny options I could pick. I picked the AIDS. I picked AIDS Resource Center, since that was one of the options.
Amazing.
And the only tweet on the entire account. I'm gonna link it to you. Oh no, I don't want it to be a bookmark. I don't want this one tweet to be my bookmark.
No, 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 make it a bookmark.
Nah. It's just
Choking my shit. Choking my shit.
the only tweet. I also don't have a banner because I think I lost the high quality version of our banner.
Fuck. So I can make the banner or anything?
No, preferably not.
Can you send me the email and password?
Right now?
On Instagram.
Yeah, because if I show the Discord screen, then we're screwed.
Yeah.
I need to. I'm gonna remember it. I'm gonna just go off the top of my head, and if I'm wrong, that's not my fault.
I'm gonna kill you if it's wrong.
That's the Twitter login, not the email login, just the Twitter login.
Okay. I understand.
Yep, don't read it out loud, because I feel like that's what you're gonna do on accident. Anyway, for our topics, do you have any before I go into my huge rampage?
Whoa.
Didn't
Whoa, what happened?
think you'd get this far. Do you have any topics?
Bane, audio made by Bane. Yo, shout out the boy Kenny though.
Okay, so that's not, you'd have no topics is what you're saying.
Yeah, I wanna hear what you think about the Jacksonville thing, because apparently you're on the Wolf's side.
What? What are you talking about? I've been very adamant that I'm
I
not.
love making shit up.
Yeah, you just. Honestly, I think that should be our new bit. We should just start making things up as we go. But anyway, so there's been. I'm not even gonna just like explain the whole thing because it should be known at this point. Sniper Wolf has completely doxxed Jack's films, just for fun, really. She just kind of did that for fun. Now the thing is, this wasn't your traditional dox. She posted a photo of his house or video of his home to her Instagram story, and the thing that I discovered about it is that it was while he was live streaming, so he like found out live and had to like stop his stream and everything because his home was being leaked and he was in potential danger. So luckily, there are people who are on Sniper Wolf's side somehow, but luckily they're all idiots. Who are, the only people who are on her side are people who are verified on Twitter, so you can't really trust them for anything.
Maybe just don't say anything. That's also a good idea, guys, but, you know.
So, because a lot of their, A lot of their, argument is because Jack harassed her that she's not in the wrong or whatever.
No.
Which just isn't true, because he was, Here, I need to find the tweet, because someone made a really good tweet about it. Jack has also pointed out when Leah has done something right. He never believed the Google Doc theory, and he's never even assumed she stole a joke. It's always had to be pointed out to him. He's literally about the content. Leah and her fans scare me. It was so, because he's always, people on the subreddit were always, talk about, her appearance or whatever, and, plastic surgery or whatever, and they have to be, shut down, because that's not the argument. No, that's not the issue. Right. It's always just been that she's stealing from creators. And especially with the Google Doc theory, he was really good where he didn't, hop on the trend of believing she was reading from a Google Doc. And it was even disproven that she was using Google Doc, and he never believed it to begin with, which I think is awesome.
Mm.
And there is something else. So, Sniper Wolf has videos from 6 to 7 years ago that are, about her being stalked or followed by a fan. And that's one thing. It's, ironic, yeah. But the bigger picture thing about that is that the fact that she made that video, those videos, show that she believes that that's weird and wrong. To an extent, knows that it's wrong enough that she has to make a video detailing her experience. So, then she goes around and does it. And I need to find more of Jack's tweets because, hold on. Yeah. Jack, there's been a lot of tweets. One of Sniper Wolf's stories is, this is obsessive behavior. Is this really the only way you can get views on YouTube? Don't you have a wife? Which I feel like is a really weird thing to throw out there. It's also the thing that the only channel they ever use to prove their argument is the channel created for this reason. They completely ignore the fact that his main channel has videos that are more bigger picture. Oh shoot, he uploaded a video about it. I didn't even see this yet. 30 minutes ago, he uploaded a video about Sniper Wolf doxing him. I kind of want to watch that. Raymond, can we pause for 3 minutes so I can go watch this?
Yeah, sure.
Hold on, we have a layout for this very reason. We have a layout that...
Yeah, but I don't think... But I'm on my data right now. I don't think I'll be able to even watch the video.
Okay, well, you can just kind of be here for comedic relief, and we can just watch. I do realize this does go against the very thing Jack is fighting for, which is to get rid of content thieves, and we would.
This goes against what? Oh, you're lagging so much right now.
We would. No, I'm not. Okay, I don't know. I don't know. I'm wondering if it's a good idea to just play this video in its entirety. It would be kind of funny.
Look at our new banner.
Oh, what did you do? Okay, that's not important. I want to watch this so badly.
Oh, fuck you.
Last night, Sniper Wolf, a massive YouTuber, showed up outside of our home, recorded a video of our home, and then posted it to her 5.6 million Instagram followers, goading me with the line, "Let's talk like adults." In my 17 years on YouTube, I've never once had someone come to my...
Did you just gasp?
What?
It just sounded like...
What the fuck are you waffling about?
Sniper Wolf needs to be deplatformed. In this exact moment, she turned from a mere content thief to someone who doxes and stalks her critics. To everyone that's reached out to us, thank you. We're fine, we're just a little shaken up. But mainly, we feel violated. We no longer feel safe in our own home. Because we're dealing with someone who genuinely thinks they're in the right for A, stalking me, and B, posting our home to her massive audience.
You're awfully quiet.
I feel like I've established why. And again, I'm not gonna play the full video. I'm just gonna stop it where I've gone to, where he mentions that she thinks she's in the right, where somehow she does. She does genuinely think she's in the right.
I don't think so.
Where she claims she has no ill intentions when she posted his address, like his home, which I'm sure her doing that in and of itself is bad and dangerous, but it's also the fact that we've seen that people are supporting her action in doing this. So who knows the length they'll go to like, you know, it's like genuine endangerment. And especially when you consider he's the only real, I guess, quote unquote target, even though that sounds much more threatening than I mean it to be, when there's other, like, there is like their dogs and wife that aren't a part of this.
Yeah.
That are also put in danger. I had a point I wanted to bring up, but I just completely forgot it.
Why are you following Joe Biden?
The new TakeTheBait account only follows Joe Biden. Shoot, I wanted to say something. I don't know. One point is that during, because in her video, it's allegedly the, like, I don't know if it's been proven, maybe it is said in this video, but I can't finish it because I don't want to, because you keep saying I'm quiet when I'm watching a video because I'm not going to be talking through it.
I'm sorry to interrupt you, but our Twitter feed is only just politicians right now.
I know, yeah, that is my, I mean, to be fair, last time you made it just Taylor Swift, which I was okay with. I think this might be worse, actually, now that I'm thinking about it.
Yeah, no, I don't like this. Take this off and be keen.
Maybe unfollow Joe Biden. Maybe unfollow Joe Biden. Oh yeah, shoot, this is bad. I just logged in. This is not good.
Okay.
Following cannot unfollow Joe Biden, and all shit. You know, I'm gonna, and then let's go follow Taylor Swift. Let's return to our roots. Yeah. Anyway,
you're only following. I was just about to follow Taylor Swift.
Yeah, I went way ahead of you, buddy.
Fuck.
Doxing is cringe. I think. Oh, that I remember what I want to say. Okay, the thing is, we're now at, Sniper Wolf has forced Jack's hand in the most interesting way possible, where it's like. If he continues posting on Judge Jack's films and continues doing this, because he's now at a point where she can't redeem herself, so he could keep going because he's at like what could be considered a final stretch. He could keep going and maybe end it for good, maybe actually change, and it could be taken down. But the issue with that is then he's put into a lot of danger because he's already in danger. So if he keeps going, he's in danger.
Yeah.
Like, as he already is. But if he stops, like, if he completely stops, which I think he should do more, like, realistically, or, like, in...
Yeah.
I think he should stop until YouTube does something. Because I think, like, this... I think everything, it could keep going as long as YouTube actually does, like, as long as something is done about it.
Yeah.
But if he stops, then she wins, and that's it. If he continues, then he's just in a lot of danger. It's a really, like, she's completely, like, it's insane what she has somehow done.
Yeah, no.
But luckily, like,
not even
within, like, a few hours, so many, like, videos were made about it, and which was good, because it was bringing more attention. I need to find... It's so weird that people are still saying Sniper Wolf is in the clear for it.
No, she ain't. No, she ain't.
Because, like, if you watch any of the bingo... Have you seen any of the bingo, like, videos?
No, I don't watch Jack's films ever.
Well, if you do, like, there's one of them where, like, he encourages creators to, like, copyright her videos. But he does it so frequently, and then he even says every now and then, like, if you weren't stolen from, don't do that. Like, I'm not trying to send a hate mob. Like, he is specific with how he does it. And, like, I don't watch it live, so I can't see the chat, but according to this random person on Twitter, every time someone in chat on his bingo streams makes this... Actually, I have a layout for this. Every time someone in chat on his bingo streams makes a statement over her appearance or something more personal, he always tells chat to stop. He never wanted to make it a personal thing. She seems to be lashing up because she's actually losing content. Which she is, because now that a lot of creators are striking, she's been forced to, like, remove it from her videos, which has been shortening them more and more, making them no longer 8 minutes.
Yeah.
And now he's been doxxed, which is insane.
It's not an equal trade-off.
It's also the thing I'm pretty sure California, it's illegal to do what has transpired.
Yeah.
That is illegal. I'm just watching this random video that's trying to claim someone farted, and it's the most edited thing ever. Sorry.
What? Someone farted?
They're trying to claim, and they put it under thermal vision, and it's just like a fake explosion in the background.
You sound like you farted. 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 Farted.
A beat on a roll.
On a roll. You are retarded. Tarded. Oh!
Oh! Anyway.
Ooh, let's talk about... Yo. Send me the clips to the Taylor concert.
I want to talk about that. So I recently went to the Taylor Swift Eras Tour movie. You don't understand how difficult getting these clips to you has been. So first of all, getting these clips, like, for you, because you asked me to record. So first of all, you asked me to record in a movie theater. That's not allowed, but I did it. You asked me to do a crime, and I pulled through.
A crime?
I'm pretty sure it's piracy, but, like, the legal one.
Piracy?
So, I originally uploaded these clips to Google Drive, and was like, once these upload, I'll just link them to you. They took, like, a whole day later, they were still uploading. I'm like, they're never gonna stop. So I tried canceling them because they were messing with my Wi-Fi and I had stuff to do. And, like, my Wi-Fi was so slow because nothing was being uploaded. And then they wouldn't cancel no matter how much I clicked the cancel button. So I just had to delete Google Drive off my phone. It's no longer there. Oh. I no longer have the app. I no longer have the app. So but because of these videos, because of these clips, which are both like 500 megabytes each, my phone storage has been destroyed, so I couldn't just edit them together or anything. I would have, and I couldn't. So what I tried to, when I did stitch them together, but when I exported it, I just set it to the lowest quality possible. Like, it was like,
oh my god.
So I even added a really,
is that at least, like, watchable.
Yeah, I was looking through it, though it did get me copyrighted on my account that I posted it to, but I will link it to you right now. I've been saving this. It is watchable. You can still see it.
Thank god.
I even put a really crappy transition between the two clips that you could tell.
Oh my fucking god. I hate you so much.
I had to add my little pizzazz to it.
Alright.
So you can,
why did you say it's so French? It's so gay.
So you can enjoy 5 minutes of the way I recorded it was really funny. I shoved my phone in the cup holder and just had it conspicuously facing up.
Poor Raymond.
And I was like all like looking at it, like I looked down, was like all like readjusting it, moving my...
Wait, this is a movie theater? I thought you were at an actual concert.
No, I established it was the tour movie.
Oh, that's still cool. Oh yeah, no, I made jokes about how you
yeah.
like the flash that the screen.
You wanted me to pretend that it was a real concert, which okay, actually this was really cute.
I would have done that. So no, I would have done that.
It was actually really cute. There were people like in like because okay, luckily the one I went to, it was not crowded at all, and I could not be more happy.
Okay.
Because one, we went on release day. Like we went when it came out. So I was really expecting it to be like the most uncomfortable thing ever. There was like no one in the same row as me. Like we were chilling. Like me and my friend, we were chilling.
You brought someone?
They brought me. I was the plus one.
You never bring me to anything.
You live in a different state than me.
Even when I was in the same state as you, you never brought me to anything.
Well,
because
when you were in the same state, we weren't that good of friends, in my opinion, and I didn't believe you were even real.
Well, at the time.
I didn't believe you were. I didn't believe you were real, to be honest. We still haven't.
Now we cooling, right?
Now I know you're real. I think.
Oh.
Anyway, so
you won't even give me confirmation.
It was not credit at all, which I was really glad. But so there were times where like. I couldn't tell if the audience, like, the audience doing anything was in the actual, like, movie thing or someone in the actual audience that I was in. It was, like, it was so, like, trippy because I was, like, looking all around trying to figure out. Because there was this one specific scream I kept hearing that was, like, quiet enough to where it could have been coming from a speaker, but also, like, too specific and too repetitive to where it couldn't have just been someone in that sold-out stadium that was in the video or the movie. Like, I was losing it. Like, I could not. But it was an enjoyable 3 hours.
3 hours? Never mind. I do not want to come.
3 hours, and I got you a 5-minute clip. Enjoy. That's in 360p.
Right, you didn't record everything, bro.
Dude, my camera could only record 11 minutes to begin with.
I would have emptied my entire phone for that.
I didn't think I was going to be illegally recording a movie theater.
Illegally recording a movie.
It was, like, really enjoyable, though.
I can imagine. I like, that'd be crazy hearing Blank Space, though. That's crazy.
I don't remember. I think I
how much was it?
I think, I don't know. I didn't ask them how much they paid, because I didn't pay.
Oh.
I brought my money in case that they wanted me to pay them back, but they never asked. So I'm like, okay. So I have.
Oh.
Oh, cool. I think one of, wait, I think, no, I don't remember. I don't remember the two, because I only have the video I sent you is just two songs I was able to, that I did record. I don't remember which ones they, I know, I think, I don't remember which ones they are, to be honest. It was 3 hours.
Okay.
Yeah, I was there for 3 hours. It was really
I hope it was Blank Space.
I don't know. I don't know if it was. It might. No. I think it's one that reminds me of Blank Space.
Okay, what?
I hope that makes sense later on. Anyway.
Does not make sense.
Dude, it was really weird. The theater, they just gave me a picture of Taylor Swift, I guess.
Okay.
I just have a photo of the woman now in my closet.
What?
Okay. Like, I'm trying to think of them. Like, I don't know what to do with that. Like, I didn't.
Why? Was it given to you? Or, like, what, how did you get it?
It was handed to me. They handed it to me, yeah. I'm sure someone out there carries. No, but it was freaking sweet. It was really cute because there was like there were some songs that like someone like in the actual like theater crowd people were singing along to, which was really cute.
Cool. How long is the? Don't say it like that. How long is the like the airing for?
3 hours.
No. I meant like. Like, how many weeks will theaters be having this song
know.
For?
I don't know. Let me check. How long will theaters have Taylor Swift? just in general. It says, according to ABC News, at least 13 weeks.
How many weeks?
At least 13.
13? Yeah!
You can go. So cool. You can watch.
Heck yeah.
Dude, my friend got the seats right in the middle. It was... Oh, but I made... So, I'm very weird. So, like, when I sat down, I was all slouched down, like, as a joke. But then I was so, like... Mm-hmm. I was too awkward to, like, get back up. So, I just, like, had to commit. And it hurt so badly. Like, my posture has been ruined. So, like, I had to, like, strategize how I got back up. Or like do it slowly.
Who else know? Who else heard of
what? What are you saying to me?
Wait, what happened?
What's your problem?
What?
You just said who else heard of
what happened?
And then stopped talking.
Oh yeah, my bad.
What's your problem?
Have you seen that one video where it's captioned "Buddy unlocked a new level of confidence," and it's like, if you go to heaven and you don't find me there, you've gone to hell. Have you seen that?
No.
No? Let me send you it.
That does remind me of another video that's also kind of like unlocking a new level of confidence. Or is this girl talking about, like, it was this girl talking about, like, how she likes nerds, and then this one guy was like, she's not talking about, like, you know, and she's talking about me. And it was painfully unironic, too. And the comments were like, wow, this is a lot of... I'm explaining it so poorly, but just know it's a lot funnier when you
watch. No, I understand.
No, you don't.
Alright, I just sent you the video.
Oh man, can't wait.
Write this down. You get to heaven and you don't find me there. You have gone to hell.
It's exactly like you explained it. I don't know what I expected, honestly. Like, I mean, yeah, the rumors were true.
But the way he, like, built it up and, like, his facial expressions, it's like, damn, he really, he knows it. He knows he will be there.
Yeah. You think I'll go to heaven? You think God's real?
No.
You don't?
I think half the world population will be going to hell.
Do you think God's real? Let's get into this.
No.
Let's talk about how last episode ended.
Yeah. If he ever was, he has left us such a long time ago. He's left us.
Let's talk about how last episode ended.
Oh, yeah. The podcast almost ended.
David has been executed.
And not by me this time.
Let's just keep it simple. David has been taken care of. He is dead.
What?
David is dead. I killed him.
Oh, okay.
Don't worry. He's gone. Like, he's dead.
Yeah.
He's been executed.
But yeah, no, it wasn't almost ended by me this time.
Dude, no, you don't understand how bad.
Wait, no, that does not sound right. It was not almost ended by me.
You don't actually understand how mad that made me, because it was the final stretch. Literally, like, And the fact that he said my last... Also, we're on thin ice here. Don't you say my last name either. It's the fact that he said my last name while we're talking about not saying last names. And he was like, ah, okay. So, I shouldn't say teachers' last names. Got it. And then says my last name two seconds after. Landon's last name, that's fine. Like, he can only remember one rule at a time, apparently. And I need to pick which one I want each day. Anyway.
You know, I've been doxed you since you threatened the end of the podcast.
I know, because I said if I get doxed one more time, it's the end of the podcast. And I was serious. And the only reason we are here today is because I had a lot to talk about. So... It honestly could have been over if it wasn't for the fact that, honestly, thank you, Sniper Wolf, for doxing Jack's film, because now I have a lot to talk about. Well, actually,
we already got through that, though.
Yeah, so now I'm kind of bored. Oh, Mario Wonder. Actually, I do have stuff to talk about. Mario Wonder has been leaked online.
You keep talking about it.
No, Mario Wonder has been leaked online. The full ROM is out in the public somewhere.
I'm sorry. I don't want to play it.
I'm not doing it either. It's like I'm choosing not to so much so that I don't even know where it's leaked. Like, I couldn't even download. I couldn't even if I wanted to. Well, actually, if I tried hard enough, I could. But that's not the point. So yeah, there's been a lot of leaks for it recently. Some of them are questionable on how real they are, just because. Can I share one that I think is fake? Just cause, and I want it only sharing it because I'm pretty sure it's fake.
Sure. Yeah. Sure.
It's a leak.
I left $1 million under the.
It's a leak that are you quoting that one Young Sheldon scene? Anyway. It's a leak that suggests that Rosalina is a secret playable character in Wonder. The reason I believe this is fake, the image actually looks pretty convincing. Let me actually find it. The reason I believe it's fake is because the level that they are in to take this picture, it does not make sense because.
Okay.
Here, let me pull this. I guess if you don't want to look at this fake leak, don't. It doesn't make sense that it would be they would have. I'm talking to the audience, buddy. That there would be I can just pull this up in a new tab. That there would be there's a pot. She's holding a pot in a wall jumping level, which does not check out in my opinion. Just in my humble opinion. Don't think that checks out. Which is why I believe it's fake. Now, I could be wrong, which it would be really unfortunate, but I mean, even if I am wrong, it's still gonna be a surprise because I think it's fake, right? Like, and I believe it is fake.
Right, yeah.
But I'm really excited for this game, and I don't want to get stuff spoiled. I have seen clips. I've seen, like the leaked clips. I've seen those. Because I've gone out of my way to see them, actually. But that's not important. Curiosity is a bitch. I'm good.
What? Like, I don't know something?
Tell me something.
No, you continue.
What? Okay.
You sounded really lost.
Because I forgot what I was going to say, because I was so, like, convinced. I was so, like, enthralled with whatever you had.
Oh, what I was going to say is that the way you make a family is not family friendly.
So one of my favorite things about one of the leaks, and this is just... Okay. One of my favorite things about one of the leaks, and it's...
You got really... again and I got embarrassed again.
One of the leaks is really funny because someone was asking like what the Wonder effect does in one of the levels, and they explained, the guy who had like videos explained it, and it was like, but that's too hard, so here's other footage, and just did not show footage of what they wanted. It's too hard to do, so I didn't. Like, that's quite, it just says, but it's too hard to do, so I didn't, here's another level. I think that's really funny.
This bitch. I swear to God.
I think it's too hard. I just didn't do it. Like, I mean, that's gangster.
It's too hard, man. I can't do this. I can't be doing too much.
It's too hard to do, so I just didn't do it. Like, I mean, he respects his own time.
I don't get paid enough for this.
Truly. I mean, I think that's honestly really funny, dude. I think more... More leakers should be like that. Has Pyro posted anything recently, actually? Their account still is a thing. Yeah, no, they haven't posted since the last direct, which is fair. Oh, wait, did the guy we were making fun of when we were talking about leaks, is his account gone? No, I think...
God, I kind of hope so, but at the same time not, because it's really funny.
Yeah, the guy who said Luigi's Casino was coming out, that sucks.
Yeah.
And also posted the worst. Oh, I think he's gone. Or unless he just... Please tell me he just deleted...
Black Fart Matter or 1989?
What is Black Fart Matter? You keep saying that to me and I don't know what it means.
So, there's this video of... And you know how TikTok, you can like respond to comments?
Yeah.
Like a video response to a comment?
Yeah.
And like the comment appears in the video to the comment you're responding to in the video?
Yes, I know. Yes, indeed.
Okay. So it said Black Fart Matter in all caps and one exclamation mark. And the lady in the video was like, man, shut the fuck up about your dumb ass. Leave me the fuck alone about Black Fart Matter.
I think you've shown me that before.
And ever since then, I just kept saying Black Fart Matter.
I think you've shown me that before.
Yeah, I have in the playlist video.
Oh, cool. Yeah, we need to do that.
We need to do that like tomorrow.
You're saying like we're running out of time. We have to do it tomorrow.
You want
to
do it like after the podcast? We can do that.
I won't stream it if we do.
Huh?
I just won't stream it if we do.
Wait, but that's the whole idea. You're streaming it.
I can just record it.
Oh, okay. Well, let's just do that then.
Okay.
Okay, let's do that after this podcast.
Okay. Or we can do it during. That could be like a podcast segment I edit down. That could just be a podcast segment I edit down, if you want. We could just do it now.
Nah. How be a main video?
No, I mean, we record it here, we do it live here, and then it's uploaded to the main channel.
Oh, okay. Alright, yeah, let's do
that. How long is the playlist, though?
I'm going to send you... Huh?
How long is the playlist?
Yeah, 16 of all YouTube shorts.
Oh my gosh. Bringing me back to my past. Oh, we forgot to mention, this is now season 2 of Take the Bait. Yeah, forgot about that one.
Oh yeah, this is season 2 of Take the Bait.
Indeed.
I'm sorry. I just generally got the name. I'm like, that was not me trying to leave. Okay.
We're officially in season 2 though, and seasons are gonna be done differently. For Take the Bait. Like, this is still episode 23. Like, this is still episode 23, despite it being a new season. You know. Yeah.
Alright, I just sent you the playlist.
Oh boy.
Remember, you have to watch all the videos on all of their lengths.
Well, that's debatable. Oh, hold on, I have so much...
Do you have a layout for this?
Hopefully. I can just use the movie layout. I can just use the movie layout.
Alright, that's fine.
Should I turn on my camera?
Yeah, sure. I want to see your live reaction.
I mean, you won't see it because I'm not turning it on Discord. I'm just turning it on for OBS. Yeah.
Well, like when I watch the video.
I need to turn off my Switch to do this for some reason. Then I need to add a whole new thing for it.
Necromancer.
Yeah, that's me. Okay, I'm gonna be all the way down here. I'm really tiny. I'm just gonna shrink myself.
Dude, the shadow boxing video. You can lose your shit at the shadow boxing video.
I can't wait. I truly can't wait. Okay. Two unavailable videos are hidden. So somehow.
Huh?
Two unavailable videos are hidden.
What? Oh, yeah.
How many of these are cemetery? I'm not watching cemetery ones.
There's only like three. That's
I know,
it.
But I'm not gonna watch.
Only three.
I'm not gonna watch a 3-minute cemetery video.
But no, it's really funny. Like, it's a funny video.
I watch High Cemetery because you quote that like daily.
High Cemetery.
High Cemetery.
Wait, am I trying not to laugh? Is that the goal?
Yes.
Oh, because I already laughed for like pity.
Fucking asshole.
Here, let me add a text that shows. Why are we doing this in the middle of a podcast? This doesn't make sense. Laughs.
Be right back.
Oh my gosh, this is your playlist. Where is the take the bait? Which one is that? Hello, friends. Raymond has left you. That's the wrong font. Who cares? SpongeBob font. Okay, Raymond. He's still gone. I'm gonna pause.
3 out of 3 laughs. Cause I feel like one laugh, like, way too early is gonna, like, fuck over the whole idea.
So I only have 3 lives, basically?
Yeah.
Alright. Let's get to gaming. Let's do it.
What's up, dude?
Nothing much. I like you.
This video is just you, honestly.
Which one?
High Cemetery.
Oh yeah.
Okay, I'm now on raccoon stealing sauce.
Like up on the. Hold on. Here, do you want to tell the?
That's a baby. That's not a sauce.
Excuse me? There's a raccoon at the table here.
Oh! There was a whole scheme! I'm now on Eminem Dance Battle. I'm gonna get copyrighted for this one, I think. Dance Battle Music? What does that mean? Does that count as a laugh? I was just, like, smiling and talking.
Hopefully.
Dance Battle loaded 7 months ago.
I like how you're concerned about how many cemetery videos there were when all I have is just Joe videos here.
Oh my gosh! I've seen one of these already! I've watched one of them! I just might be able to do this.
What are you watching now?
I'm still on That's Weird.
That's weird. Would you be a good old friend and subscribe?
Oh, now I'm still on That's Weird. Why did he have an outro for this YouTube short?
Hey, babe. I was wondering, can I have a boy, best friend? Or what?
I don't know who's Kentrol.
I'm not trying to be funny.
There's lore behind these videos.
I don't care about that lore then.
I don't know. We could like FaceTime. We can
do that. Are you on GF once a BF now? BBF.
BBF. You're thinking of someone else right now?
Babe, it's not that serious. I just want to meet new people. That's it.
I don't care. I'm skipping this one.
What? Which one?
BFF. Now I'm on 6 inches.
Dude, you can't. You have to watch all of them in full.
I want to see if I've seen.
That's the rule.
I want to see if there's any of these that I've actually just seen in its entirety. Dude, I don't think I'm gonna laugh. The closest I've gone is the owl, because he just kept making the same noise over and over. So I might be close.
You have to watch all of them in full, though. Like, that's the rule.
I don't like that a baby is saying that.
Yo, who?
Please get me to 200k subs on YouTube.
Oh.
Get
me. He's already on 200k. Why does he want it again?
I'm fine.
You donated 693 times.
Is this just a movie clip? Is this just a clip from a movie? You can't just send me movie clips.
Between 1991 and 1994,
but they're on YouTube Shorts.
Sperm under the pseudonym Starbuck.
A film. The film name is Delivery Man. I represent. Apparently.
No, that was yeah, that's me. That's literally me.
We have all the documents necessary to prove.
Is this even funny, or did you just put any video that was on your shorts feed on this playlist? I think that's what you did.
I found it funny.
You donated 693 times, in exchange for which you received the sum of $24,255. Your sperm is of a very high quality.
Thank you.
I'm sure you still only donated 600 plus times.
certain complications arose, which meant that for a period, Mr. Grabowski-Levitt gave your sperm to.
The scene didn't even finish.
I think I just might be able to do this one.
Now I'm on stop. Let's watch. Where's my mouse? Oh, there it is.
Oh, stop right there. You're not getting any gifts.
You still on stop?
Yeah, it doesn't end.
Look at you.
It never ends.
TikTok, like a good little NPC. Now you'll be a
oh boy, 13 second video. He started crying after loosing.
Loosing.
Is this the official? Is this the guy who made the video? Or is this just a repost? I need to know these things.
Why do you need to know that?
Can you trespass on your own property?
Dude, I don't want to know about. These aren't funny. This is just a video about the law.
I told you I don't want you coming here anymore.
We can work things out. Give me another chance.
Ron, we're getting divorced. If you don't leave, I'll call the cops on you for trespassing.
But it may be loud.
My name. I can't trespass on my own property.
You can and you are. When the judge granted me possession of the house, aka.
I think the background music might get us copyrighted. Isn't the background music didn't even notice or whatever that song is called?
I don't know.
Someone said I'd never get invited to a good party. This is just. Cool. Oh boy, mosquito slay.
Not the mosquito again. Slay. Slay.
Dude, I'm on 2x speed and nothing feels different. I still feel like my brain is rotting.
It's even funnier on a faster speed.
Slay.
I just get out.
I feel like you're worried about me, about my fetus.
I'm on caught cheating.
So stupid to keep coming back to you.
Oh no. Oh no.
Get out, bro.
No, I'm sorry.
I don't want to hit out of that. I don't want to hit out of that shit. Get out.
Hey Raymond, do you want to talk about the Scott Pilgrim trailer that came out recently?
Wait, we'll wait after. We'll keep that on the back burner.
No, I think we'll keep this on the back burner.
No. You're halfway through, my guy.
No, I'm not. I'm 14 out of 65 videos through.
Come on, bro.
No. We'll do this at a different time.
Why not?
I have not laughed once, and I don't think I'm gonna laugh. Ever. I think
but there's so much more.
And we'll see those at a later time. The time is not today.
I'm gonna kill you, bro.
Good. Let's talk about Scott Pilgrim.
You really gave up.
Dude, I think you have issues.
We didn't even get to puberty hits guy while singing.
I've already seen that video. Me and what? The,
okay, we could have at least waited till Coke bring on. There's mom.
There's actually a funny story about the puberty video, because my cousin and I, a long time ago, randomly thought of that video and just like we're losing it, losing our minds at it.
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
Like, we randomly thought of that video and found it again, and we, like, were stalking the guy trying to find his new videos and see how he was doing.
Bro.
I have to pee so badly.
What?
Nothing.
You really hated my feed, huh?
I don't think... I think the playlist, there it could be funny, maybe, if I wasn't, like... If I didn't have, I don't know. I'm sure it's funny. I'm sure it.
You didn't even laugh at a single one of them.
I smiled at one of them, though. You have to consider that.
You smiled.
Actually, I think I smiled more because I zoomed in on my face cam and my deadpan face was making me lose it. I thought it was really funny because I just like zoomed in and then just. I thought that was funny. So, yeah. I still have my camera on, Raymond.
I didn't even watch the trailer.
I still have my... Oh, you didn't watch the new trailer? So, I'm a better Scott Pilgrim fan than you, is what you're saying?
No, because I don't have the internet to do that.
Oh. So, you don't care, is what you're saying?
I what?
You don't care?
That's not what I said.
Oh, I understand. You don't care about Scott Pilgrim.
That's not what I said at all.
This is too confusing.
What do you mean you didn't watch the Scott Pilgrim trailer if you're homeless? What? You don't care?
Yeah, dude. Honestly. Dude, it's getting too silent. I feel like we're really awkward after you... Yeah, I think you're embarrassed. I think... It's so quiet right now. It's like I'm all confused and you're embarrassed about me, how I reacted to your playlist.
Wait, what happened? I'm embarrassed?
It's really quiet. And my joke theory is that it's because you're all embarrassed about how I reacted to your playlist.
You didn't even get to the deep cuts. The deep cuts are so good.
What? I don't think you know what deep cuts mean, buddy. I don't think you know
when
what
it's
that means.
When it's not the most, like hyped thing, the hyped song on the album.
No, what? No, it's...
But it's really good.
Hold on. Let me quickly look up deep cuts. All right, let me quickly specify meaning. Deep cuts meaning, not that... Yeah, something that is recognizable.
Why are there dancers around Taylor in this video?
Dude, the dancers are like my favorite part in the whole thing.
She just has an orchestra everywhere she goes?
I don't think in real life, but... Oh, ew, why is my hair like that? I don't have light, I can't see anything.
You're just getting pictures of people with deep wounds.
Are you delayed? Can you hear me what I'm saying right now?
Yes.
Why did you just respond to my deep cuts segment?
I don't know.
Anyway, dude, the dancers were like my favorite part. They were so good.
They're a good orchestra, yeah.
Yeah, the dancers were so good.
You keep ignoring my orchestra joke.
I don't get what that means. It's not an orchestra.
You don't give a fuck?
What? That's not what I said.
I feel like that one cheating video right now that you just watched and didn't laugh at.
I didn't understand that video, so I don't know what that means.
What do you mean? Because you didn't watch all of it.
Hmm. You're right, yeah, I only got 18 seconds in.
Yeah, and then you were like, I don't want this anymore. No, what? You're a fake ass friend.
What?
You won't endure pain with me.
We've endured a lot.
What about jerking off?
What? I think you're just I think you're just hearing what you want to hear.
Yeah, that's what. No.
Oh yeah. Anyway, I think episode 5 of Gen V is the greatest that they've had.
Okay, I didn't watch it yet.
Why did my how'd that happen? My background just got bigger.
I didn't watch Gen V, so I don't know what you're talking about. I can't agree to disagree.
You should watch it, honestly.
Okay, give me your account.
I watch it illegally, buddy.
You watch it what? How?
Illegally.
And you shit on me?
Because you download indie games illegally. I think that's a little bit more questionable.
Okay, but it's Undertale. Like, that's, like, super popular. And I already gave Castlet my money. Wait, I already gave Undertale my money, too. Wait.
That's not an argument.
Wait, I have Undertale on Steam.
Then where did you pirate it?
No, you had to pirate it because you didn't own it.
I do own it.
Oh, okay.
I'll literally show you. Hold on. I do own this. I mean, I won't show you. I'll show the podcast. I'll show the audience, and then you can watch this later
on.
No,
they don't care.
I know. You will watch
this. I'm the audience, and I don't care.
Yes, you do. You will watch this later on and be like, oh, he does have Undertale. And be like, okay.
You didn't care enough about my player, so I won't care about what's in your Steam library.
Oh, it's not my Steam library, so we're good.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's okay
you
now.
You have some weird games in there.
On my Steam library?
Yeah, you have some really weird games.
You know what? Are you doing this bit where you lie again?
Yeah.
Undertale.
What do you think about the track listing of this album?
What album?
I'm still weeping. I cannot pray.
You know what we can talk about? So we're past an hour, so if you want to go home, you can. Alternatively, we can talk about the boys.
Go home.
We can talk about the boys if you so desire.
No, but that's going to be spoilers. Why do you hate Ryan so much?
Dude. Oh, I can't swear on the podcast. I hate Ryan.
Yeah, you said the word fuck so many times. Like, I've never heard you say that word
it
like
was so
that many times.
Passionate. I hate Ryan.
Why? Explain. Because he's still a child. Like, I don't understand.
Every problem revolves around him. Every problem is his fault. Okay.
I see it now.
Hold on, let me get a text on the screen that just is. Yeah, let me get Minecraft. Yeah, sure. The boys spoilers. Let me get that real big so no one. I mean, who's gonna watch this? But real
so
big.
So no one can email at us and complain.
Yeah, so no one can send us emails and be really upset. The boys. Spoilers from probably here on out, honestly.
Per Krantz.
I hate Ryan because he, the entire purpose of Butcher was to get Becca back. And then Ryan is like, whoops, killed her. My bad.
Yeah, but he has powers he's never known or seen before. Of course he doesn't know. And plus, like, wasn't, like, Homelander, like, beating up on Becca, too? Like, at the moment, like, he was mad as shit, of course. Like, I don't understand. He can't control that shit. I don't know, bro.
I get he can't control it. I'm
like,
still mad at him
meant
for it.
If to do that, then yeah, I'm on your side. Fuck Ryan.
I don't
but, like,
think he meant to do
child.
It. I'm not saying he meant to do it. I'm just saying I hate him for doing it.
Dude.
Okay. Wait, on the wiki, he has an enemies list? Oh, his enemy is just Stormfront.
Enemies list?
His one enemy is Stormfront, because she kidnapped him. Which what? I guess is fair.
Oh.
I guess that's fair to hate her. And other reasons to hate Stormfront, yeah. Let's be honest, but...
Yeah.
Oh, that's funny. So, Becca is listed as accidental victim. To Ryan.
Yeah.
I love calling it a victim so much.
Victim? Yeah, she's a victim to Ryan. Yeah, status deceased. Wonder why. Cause of death. Fatal neck wound accidentally caused by Ryan using heat vision. Fucking Ryan. It's his fault.
Accidental.
Soldier Boy was his attempted killer.
I don't know, bro.
Dude, what? There's so many, like, attempted... Yeah, Stormfront was an attempted victim. But Becca was an accidental victim. Soldier Boy was an attempted killer. So much is going on for this boy. And it's deserved. It's also like, why did he choose to be born if he knew Butcher wasn't his dad? That's a little weird.
I don't know.
Let's see, where's Billy Butcher? His stepfather. Why is Homelander listed as his father and savior?
His father and savior?
Yeah. His father
what
and
the fuck?
Father and savior.
That's some religion shit right there, bro.
Dude, Butcher's 6'5".
Yeah, that's not surprising.
It isn't. Wait, hold on. How tall?
Like in the show or in your life?
In the show, but I'd assume in real life because it's a live-action show, buddy. How tall is Homelander, then? How tall is Homelander?
I like to think that if for, like, an adaptation of, like, an animation or, like, comic book, like, they have to give, like, the actors, like, surgery to, like, fit the description.
Do you know what Huey in the comics looked like, buddy?
No, I didn't watch the comics.
He does not look like what he looks like in the show, I'll tell you that much. Let me show you a quick photo of the guy.
Yeah, but he still fits him.
Are you sure? You've seen him. You've not seen him, actually.
No, I haven't.
Let me show you what Huey looks like in the comics. Because he does not look like Jack Quaid, I'll tell you that much.
I fucking hate Jack Quaid. You took my life away in Minecraft.
He did. That was awesome.
I have to wait for this to load now.
Well, it will eventually, and it's gonna be awesome.
Okay.
Anyway, Homelander is 5'11", which means, does that mean Huey is, like 6 foot? If he's tall, if he's, since Huey is taller than Homelander, who's enemy?
I don't know.
I wonder who.
How tall is Homelander?
Homelander is 5'11". He's 5'11".
Ain't no way. That's crazy.
Whoa, Huey is listed as an attempted victim and killer. So Huey, I didn't even realize Huey ever tried to kill Homelander. That's insane. Huey is 6'1".
Bro, that is not Huey. That's. Who's the other dude? Like the bald dude.
Frenchie,
yeah, that's Frenchie, bro. That's
no,
not
it's not.
Huey.
That is what Huey. That is what Huey looks like in the comics.
Yeah. Man, I would not watch the comics because
you,
of
you
this
can't.
Now.
You can't watch comics. Actually, you actually read them, which I know is tough for you since you don't go to school. But you read, yeah.
Shut your throat vocals.
Anyway. Huey is 6'1", which is taller than Butcher.
Damn. How is he not beating ass?
Huey? Huey is. I love Huey. Don't ever hate on Huey.
No, I fuck with Huey. Don't worry.
Dude, my friend, me and my friend had a full debate about Huey, and it was, I won, because Huey's the best.
You can't say I won in a debate. A debate isn't about, like, winning.
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not. It's the sole purpose of debating is to at least make sure that the other side sees what you see. You know, like, it's not, like, yeah, you can prove points here and there, and you can give, like, facts, but you can't, but your overall point in a debate cannot be just to win. Because if that's the whole point of a debate, you're going to live a... You're gonna live a horrible life.
But I did win, is the thing. I convinced my friend that Huey was a good character.
Okay.
That was the goal, was to convince her that Huey was a good character, and I did it.
Okay.
You don't understand, I spent all day reading the wiki. Like, that, unironically, that's all I was doing.
Was this, like, on text or, like, actual, like, school?
Half and half.
Oh. So after you guys got out of school, you continued the conversation.
Yeah, that's actually what happened, yeah. Dude, Robin. Yep.
She's dead.
Spoilers! Why is the cause of death so specific? Pulverized in a high velocity impact by A train. It's so specific. She's at least in four episodes somehow, and not in just
what
one.
What do you think about A train?
A train? I think.
What do you think about the deep?
Let's get into A train, because A train I like as a character. Not like. I don't like his. I don't like the character. I like them as a character, though. Though in season 3 episode 1 he has one of the funniest lines, which is when he sees Huey and asks him what his suit is, like what brand, and he was like, oh, I don't know, and A-Train's like, I don't care, honestly, I just don't care, and then just went on with his day, and I thought that was hilarious. It's like, I don't care.
I don't care. That's me for real.
Yeah. I need to rewatch all of I need to rewatch all of the boys. I've been just sporadically rewatching episodes because season 2 episode 5 is my favorite episode in the entire series. First of all, let's get that out of the way.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Hold on, let me look. I want to see the wiki page for the episode. The boys season 2 episode 5. We got to go now. It is my favorite episode because I love my favorite thing in the entire show is purely just Butcher and Huey. I like everything else in the show, but my favorite thing is Butcher and Huey. Because this episode there is one scene where Butcher's like, I'm leaving the grid. I'm going to Argentina, I guess. And then Huey's like, you could have said goodbye, and it was so upset. And I think that's beautiful.
Yeah, because like it shows like Huey, he cares about people and shit.
And then the
and
line,
they had a good friendship too.
The line
I don't know if it was one sided, but yeah,
it wasn't. Huey Butcher says something to Huey, and we like called him something like his canal, and like thanked him. And then I want to find. I liked Season 3, episode 7, we talked about this, as my favorite line in the entire show, and it's when Huey is trying to save Butcher, and he says, I want to be the guy who saves his family, and for better or for worse, he's family. And that's my favorite line in the entire show. And I stand by that.
It's really good.
I need season 4 so badly.
Me too, dog. I'm so excited. I'm so excited to see the turnout because, you know, as we saw in the finale of season 3, you know, like Homelander, he's always had an ego, but his ego boost after straight up killing someone right in front of, like, an audience of people and they all cheered him on, like, that's scary. Like, what could he, because he always had to worry about what the public would think. He couldn't just act on something. He always acted on something, but he always had to be careful about his ego points and, you know, what the public will think. That always scared him. Like, you can see, right, when in that one scene where Starlight puts the camera in front of a Homelander to you know, to like show that, yo, I'm on Instagram live, like dude, this is gonna tarnish your reputation. Like, you can see in the fear in his eyes that, like, oh fuck, this might be the end of my career. They all just heard that, but now that he's straight up just killed someone, just basically, well, I mean, like, again, like, you can't really just throw something at, you can't really just disrespect a kid like that right in front of their father, but, like, you know, killing is a little, you know, over the top, but I digress. But after straight up killing someone, and everyone just cheered him on, and they were just like, yeah, that's fire. What could he do now right in front of the public with their support? What else could he do now? You know, because he's already done some outlandish things already. Like, just behind the scenes. Like, behind the scenes, like, no one knows about this. He has done so much terrible things right behind the scenes. What could he do now in front of all these people? You know? that scares the shit out of me. So yeah, I'm excited for season four.
Yeah. And so Gen V surprisingly isn't a prequel like I thought it would be. It takes place like during season 3 and maybe even season 4. And we know this because they mention like Starlight and stuff. Like they mention Homelander killing the innocent guy, like in the audience. They mention that. The way Gen V has been, it's been really incredible. Where like the references haven't been spoon fed or fan service. It hasn't been too much fan service or any at all, honestly. They've been really good with it. I'm pretty sure Soldier Boy is in the next episode somehow. I'm just really scared on how they're gonna do it, and I just don't want it to be I just don't want it to be fan service-y. But there's one scene in Gen V, it's like going through like news stations, and there's like for a small bit of time one of the news that's covering the Homelander incident of him killing someone, and it like is talking about a trial, which I think is interesting because I don't think a trial happens in season 4 or is even mentioned, or in season 3. I don't think it's mentioned or happens, which means Gen V would be a little bit after season 3.
Yeah.
My concern with season 4 is I don't want a viewer to have seen Gen V to enjoy season 4 of The Boys. That's my concern. I feel like they're going to tie it in together. If they like do a subtle reference, I guess that's fine. Like, it doesn't matter. But I don't want it to be like a plot point that somebody from Gen V like joins the Seven or something. I mean, I guess they could act. It depends. It depends what like they do.
I just hope that they can be tied together, but like you don't have to see the other to enjoy the other.
Yeah, I don't think they could do that Seven thing. It needs to be done in a way where you don't have to have seen all of Gen V to understand this. They need to do it like the exact same way anyone else has been shown to join the Seven, at least in The Boys.
Yeah,
where it's just like they're here. Like that's what they're gonna. Yeah. That's what I think. But even then, I don't even know if they're gonna do that. But Gen V has clearly been planned for a while because it's referenced in season 3 of The Boys, so they've been planning this for a while.
I just hope they're all both done well, and also they can they can interconnect, but like you know, like I don't want to have to watch another whole show so I can understand what's going on in this other show. You know,
I think you should watch Gen V regardless, though. I think it's good. It's really good.
Yeah. Perhaps I will.
Just because one person told you it's bad, I don't think that should be what makes your decision.
No, I just said that to piss you off.
It's really good. I like it a lot. Especially episode 5. Episode 5 was so good.
Yeah.
So good, Raymond. Well, it was so good.
So good. He's going to start crying now.
It was so good. They invented lesbians.
No way.
But I'm excited for season 4 of The Boys.
Same, bro.
It's confirmed Butcher dies. Like, I mean, not season 4, but we know Butcher will die. Story wise, Butcher dies because his brain is mush. Literally on the wiki for his like status, it says alive and in parentheses terminally ill.
I wonder how that. I wonder how they're gonna do his deterioration.
Though. I wonder,
like, knowing all the things he's like gone through. You know, like his brother and Rebecca and whatnot. Like, I really wonder how like the deterioration of a human mind would you know incorporate that and put that in, what's the word I'm looking for? Like
put it in motion.
I don't know, like incorporate that. I don't know. I just want to know how they would like do that, you know, and make it good, you know. Like, I wonder how that would be. Like, will it be like his brain deteriorates, but he's like completely like coherent throughout the rest of season 4, or will his coherentness like go and go and go until like he's just a vegetable at the end and then dies?
I think
how will they do that?
I think it's gonna do something where like he pretends he's fine. But then, like, slowly but surely, like, more issues arise. like, in things he does where it's, like, that's not normal or, like, something he says or, like, I imagine there's at least, I can picture it perfectly. There's going to be one scene where he, like, beforehand says that he's fine. And then they're going to have a scene where a character explains a full plan and he just stares blankly. That's going to happen. I can guarantee it.
Bruh. But, I was just thinking in my mind that like they're, like, like they're in the middle of a mission and, like, they have, like, one final piece of, like, a puzzle to do. And then, like right at the last moment, he's, like, he just passes out. He wakes up and he's, like, what am I supposed to do now? That's how I think it will happen. Yeah.
I think, I'm just hoping they handle it well and not, like, rushed. And I don't think they're going to rush it.
Yeah.
But, I mean, I hope they don't, like, do it in a sense where, like, they, I don't know how to explain it, where, like, they think it wouldn't make sense to focus on it when I feel like it maybe should be.
Yeah.
I just hope Huey has character redemption. I like Huey already. People don't, and I want people to like my boy.
I don't understand. I always liked Huey, even at the end. Like you can tell, like, he's been a flawed character.
I like the reason his character does a lot of the things, which it's usually, like, he does.
Yeah, same.
Like, he takes Gen V so he feels like he has power, which is so eminent throughout Season 3 when he can't even open a jar of something because he's not strong and is always being saved by Starlight. And so him doing Gen V just for that power, and then him kind of having redemption at the end where he chooses not to take it and just help in unorthodox ways by, like, turning up the light so Starlight has more power.
Yeah.
Like, I think that was good, redemption. But I love, but I not, but yeah, I love I Huey as a character I so never much.
Yeah. Like, I generally just never understood the hate for Huey. Like, I think people just hate weak people. I think that's just it. They just hate people in general. I don't know. I really don't understand for the hate for Huey, though. Like, I don't get it. I there's no, like I'm not, like, I don't have no, like, high amazing explanation as to why people hate Huey. I just don't understand. Like, I can't wrap my head around it.
I think main reason is just that he's annoying and, like, whiny.
Bruh.
Which, like, the reason just mostly stems from, like, he's surrounded by, like, characters like Butcher, MM, or Frenchie, who are, like, awesome as characters. And then Huey is also just there, which I love. Oh, dude, Huey's so good. He's so good. Dude, I saw a comment that, like, completely changed me as a man. I need to find it. It was on the scene about of Translucent's death, because I was rewatching, like, some scenes to talk about Huey specifically. Yeah. One of the, so it's specifically the scene where he, like, gets blown up by Huey. And one of the comments, because, like, you know, like, if you don't remember how the scene plays out, Huey pretends to let him free and then, like, just decides to blow him up as he's walking away. Someone in the comments said, it would have been cool if they showed that Translucent blew up closer than he appeared to go. Like, he's immediately coming after Huey after turning invisible. Which I think is a really fun, is a really cool concept. And I'm now a changed man after reading it.
Damn, that's crazy, bro.
But yeah, I love analyzing this scene so much. Because I sent you, like, I was all being, like, a weird little guy about it. I love this scene. I like Jack Quaid's acting in the show so much. I feel like it's underrated.
Huh?
I feel like Jack Quaid's acting in the show was so underrated.
Yeah, and again, that stems from the hate from him, which, again, I don't understand, but, like, his acting, when it needed to be good and, like, when it mattered, like, it was so good. It was really, really good.
It's so many
scenes where, like, it was so well done.
It's so easy to mess up a scene, like, in the first episode with Robin's death. It's so easy to do that poorly, to, like, act that badly. It's so easy to do that.
Yeah.
And he did it well. Like, he actually did that scene, pretty well. Where,
yeah. And
I mean, as well as you could.
Yeah. like, and him explaining to Starlight, like, why he's taking the, like, the Gen V and whatnot, and how like, he hates being, like, you know, the bottom dude and whatnot. Like, it was done so well as well. Like, oh my god. And there's so many scenes where it's just done so, like, his acting is done so amazingly. Especially the scene where he's explaining, like, all of his, all like, why he takes the, like, sorry, not the Gen V. What am I fucking talking about? The temporary V?
Yeah,
I'm sorry, my bad. That's my mistake. Or like, what was the one? What was the other scene?
I think the scene where he tries to save Butcher is also pretty, like, really well done.
Oh yeah.
Where, like, you can actually, like, it feels like there's desperation there, like, genuinely.
Yeah.
Like, I'm watching the Robin scene in, because I was like, for the, like, it's like, I feel like it would be really, this is the first episode as well, and, like,
yeah,
you don't, I mean, I would imagine you probably wouldn't fully understand the premise of anything yet, so, like, with what you had, you're trying, like, you have to, like, get into the mindset of a man who just watched someone you're a huge fan of kill your girlfriend on a quote-unquote accident.
Right.
And then the rest of this episode is also just, like, the first episode is so good. Like, it's amazing.
Yeah. Like, it set the mood, for what the show was going to be completely. And it was interesting. Like, the first time I watched it, I was, like, completely glued in. Like, straight up. Like, it was just already amazing. I was like, oh, yeah, this shit's going to be good. I didn't even need to watch the second episode. Because for me, usually, like, it has to take, like, until, like, episode 3 for me to be like, okay, this show's good. No. Episode 1, I was like, okay, yeah, no, I'm ready.
I was kind of weird about the first episode because I liked it, like, when watching it. But, like, in the second episode where they kill Translucent in the really creative way where, like, they put a bomb in him, it really, like, set, like, in my mind, I thought the rest of the show was going to be them attempting to, like, kill the Seven one by one, and it just wasn't.
Yeah.
Like, that is what I expected. Like, because they were able to take down Translucent, and I was like, okay, so now, like, their goal is just going to be to slowly take down each of the Seven. And anytime the Seven has died, it's been because of Homelander.
Yeah.
So, that's unfortunate. I need to rewatch the show before season 4 comes out, probably.
I'll probably do the same too, just to keep myself up on everything.
Especially with season 2, I don't remember. I don't remember most of season 3, but I did rewatch the first episode of season 3, which was a mistake. I had to close my eyes for that one scene. I didn't want to. I've experienced
the body horror and the voice is amazing.
I experienced it once before.
It doesn't pull. Sorry.
Go ahead, buddy.
Like, okay, so, like, I love how this show, like, it doesn't censor, it rarely censors itself, like, it's just always, like, on the nose about, like, what's just about to happen. Like, when they killed, like, the motherfucking whale, that shit was crazy. Season 3, episode 1, that was also crazy, but just the general, and the scene where in Homelander's mind, he wanted to kill everyone in the audience when they're booing him and stuff. Like, they don't skimp out on the body horror at all. Like, there's so many times where I generally just had to close my eyes because I was like, okay, dude, what the freak?
Yeah, there's only two scenes I've had to close my eyes for, and it was, or, like, just look away from it, or skip it, not close my eyes. But there were two times I just had to skip, And it was that scene where the girl's fingering the Deep's gills. That
don't
it was that one, and then there's one scene where Black Noir kills someone in, like, a really way where he, like, does it, like, with his, like, jaw and, like, breaks it. It was, I couldn't, because it was slow as well, so the second I understood what was happening, I was like, nah. But the cocaine,
you didn't have to remind me of that.
The cocaine penis, I was able to endure the first time just because I didn't know it was going to happen. Now that I do know, I am terrified. I'll say Gen V has another penis scene if you're interested in that stuff. It's not as bad. It's not as bad at all. No. It's not that. It's not as bad. It's if anything, it's actually funnier, I think.
But dude, it's funnier.
I'm
you did not have to remind me of the guilt.
I'm scared.
You did not know. Okay,
hold on. I'm scared for season 4 because they've said that they've done something worse than the cocaine penis.
Oh, no.
What could that be? My friend and I have been like speculating. She's dead convinced it has something to do with like a baby or something. I don't know what that means, but
no, actually, there's this scene actually in the comics. My brother told me about this. This is the I'm pretty sure like Homelander like raped someone else. That could be it.
But I don't know if that would be.
That could be it.
Because it was the actor for Homelander who said it, so that it has to be something Homelander related. So that is possible, but I don't know if that would be considered worst. I know that's a really bad thing, but I'm in context of The Boys, would that be worse than the penis?
I know that's a really bad thing, but
because I don't want to say like I don't think that's that bad. That's what I'm trying to say. I'm just trying to think like in the context of what The Boys has shown. Would that, or has done even, would that really top it? To be fair, though, that is it's the actor of Homelander saying that, who seems to just be a really nice person. So maybe for him, that was really bad, which honestly is possible. That could be it, honestly.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be surprised.
God, you did not have to remind me of the ghost. Because it looks so real, too. Like, it looks like it's actually just a part of it.
It's so well done, and it's bad that it's well done.
Yeah, I don't like that, bro. Like, And plus, if you actually know how sensitive those fish skills are, and, like, how, if you even, like, touch them, like, they hurt, like, like, if you know how sensitive they are, like, not like, you know, that good kind of sensitive, like, the bad kind of sensitive, like, it actually, like, hurts them like hell. Like that scene, it hurts to watch even more.
My headphones are off.
My headphones are off.
I can't wait for you to rewatch this just to see, like, my camera, because it's just, I'm just, like, doing things in the background. I'm just kind of doing stuff.
Okay.
We've been here for like an hour and a half.
I think we can end it here.
I was about to say, yeah, do you think that it's time?
Yeah. I think we're good. We got a good, genuine conversation in, so yeah, we're good.
We got a failed try not to laugh challenge in as well.
Bro, that shit sucked. I really wished you got more into the deep cuts.
Okay, Kermit the Frog. I really wish. Anyway. Raymond. Let's brofist it out.
Get married.
We're getting married? Dude, next. That's the.
Remember, I have that robot account ready just to.
Dude,
do that, just
okay, hold on, hold on. Happened. I know. So since season one of Take the Bait ended with like specials, I think season two should end on a marriage special.
Yes, please. Yes, yeah.
We have a giant wedding.
Yes, that has to be it. When's the next holiday?
Thanksgiving. We could actually do a Thanksgiving special. That's actually not bad.
Yeah, Thanksgiving and marriage. Yeah, okay,
I think
yeah,
Thanksgiving special could just be a genuine. Like we bring on maybe like Jade or something, someone, and it's just like a purely we just have genuine conversations with each other. I think that could actually be cool.
Yeah, and plus, like, Thanksgiving is a free day, so, like, yeah.
That's true.
And yeah, then, like, there's no school. Like, we have no reason not to.
Or we could do something for Christmas as well, maybe. And I'll be in a new house by these specials as well, so I have, like, infinite range. But, yeah, I think that would... Yeah. I think we need to do more holiday specials. We should maybe do an actual Halloween special.
I was thinking of that, but I don't know how we're going to do that.
I think we should just do an episode that's uploaded on Halloween that just has the spooky layout. I think I just, like, sure. I think that's just a, anyway.
Yeah, that's fire.
Do the outro, Raymond. Okay. I have to pee so badly. I've had to pee for the past hour.
So, guys.
Is that it? Are you done? I look so tired.
So I show speed. He bought an iPhone 15 on stream. but he actually like leaked his address.
Am I supposed to be surprised?
His dad made a song called I showed my knee to make you feel complete, that his dad actually made that song.
That's fun. I don't know how this is an outro. It feels like you're just making the podcast go on even longer. It feels like you're trapping me here.
Okay. Play the outro track to my first one off the record.
That's the Mario theme. Mario boss theme from Mario Wii.
Did you know if you look at it, all of the full NAPTA records, you'll see on the Bandcamp page it says all rights reserved, but they're all sampled, uncleared samples.
Well, I want to see how frozen I can stand. I can sit.
I don't want to see.
You just. Oh shoot! This way. What's that? What's that doing there?